Hello and welcome to Answering ATPL. This video will briefly discuss aircraft magnetism and compass swing or ATPL general navigation examination preparation. This video is divided into three sections. Section 1, causes and effects of aircraft magnetism. Section 2, compass swing. And section 3, deviation. Section 1, causes and effects of aircraft magnetism. Although all aircraft are constructed mainly of non-ferrous material, they are fitted with engines, instruments, and electrical circuit, which may produce magnetic field. The aircraft magnetic field distort the Earth's magnetic field and produce errors in aircraft compass reading. The aircraft magnetic field is the product of hard iron and soft iron magnetism. Hard iron magnetism is permanent and does not change with location and direction. However, the effect of hard iron magnetism on aircraft compass reading depends on the H component strength. Lower H component strength will result in a more significant influence of hard iron magnetism on compass reading. Soft iron magnetism is temporary. It results from the interaction between aircraft structure, electrical system, and Earth magnetic field. Soft iron magnetism changes with location and direction. Location changes of concern for soft iron magnetism are in terms of latitude changes. Changes in latitude affect the compass angle of dip and the amount of the H component, which affect the amount of influence exerted onto the compass system by aircraft magnetism. The resultant of hard iron and soft iron magnetic field causes the aircraft compass not to point to the magnetic north. The direction in which the aircraft compass is pointing is known as compass north. The difference between compass north and magnetic north is known as deviation. More about deviation later. Significant effort is required to analyze and compensate the aircraft compass. This occurs during a compass swing. Section 2, compass swing. The term compass swing is used to describe the procedure for the calibration of the compass. During compass swing, aircraft need to turn in several directions. Aircraft compass reading in this direction are compared to datum compass reading taken outside of the aircraft by technician. The number of directions that need to be compared depends on the occasion and operator requirements. Compass swing cannot take place at any location. Compass swing bay is a designated location free of local magnetic interference, away from building, machinery, power lines, etc. The aircraft system should be as near as practical to a normal operating state, with the engine running above alternator threshold, radio and nav aids on. Compass swing procedure is designed to determine aircraft deviation on a series of headings, correct for deviation, and record residual deviation. As the residual aircraft magnetism can change, it is common for aircraft to be swung at least once a year. Some occasions when a compass swing is considered necessary are as follow. When replacing or installing compass components, whenever the accuracy of the compass is in doubt, after a maintenance inspection if required by the schedule, after a significant aircraft modification, repair or replacement involving magnetic material, when carrying unusual ferromagnetic payloads, when the compass has been subjected to significant shock, if the aircraft has been struck by lightning, after significant modification to aircraft radio or electrical systems, after the aircraft is transferred to another base involving a large change in latitude, if the aircraft has been in long-term storage standing on one heading. Section 3. Deviation. The arrow on the screen indicates the direction of magnetic north. If compass north lead to the west of magnetic north, deviation is west. Let's say the angular value is 10 degrees. We can write the deviation value as 10 degrees west or negative 10 degrees. If compass north lay to the east of magnetic north, deviation is east. We can write it as 10 degrees east or positive 10 degrees. By the way, don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified when I publish a new content. An aircraft is flying on heading 135 degree magnetic. Magnetic heading is measured from magnetic north to the aircraft nose or the direction it is pointing. The compass deviation is 15 degree west. Compass heading is measured from compass north to the aircraft nose or the direction it is pointing. Therefore, compass heading is 150 degree. Mathematically, we can write the relation as 135 minus negative 15 equal to 150, or magnetic heading minus deviation equal to compass heading. The graphic on the screen depicts what happened when the deviation is east. We can write the relation as 135 minus positive 15 equal to 120, or magnetic heading minus deviation is equal to compass heading. Therefore, magnetic heading minus deviation equals compass heading is a correct formula. It can be rewritten as compass heading plus deviation equal to magnetic heading. This formula is the origin of the CDM table. On your screen is the CDM table. The general direction of operation for this table is from left to right. Let us look at a couple of examples to understand how to calculate using this table. Example 1. Compass heading equal 0.7 degree. Deviation equal 5 degree west. Find magnetic heading. Insert the value into their appropriate column. 5 degree west is equal to negative 5. The value that we want is magnetic heading. Therefore, we need to calculate from left to right. Since we are calculating in the same direction as the general direction, we do not have to invert any sign. 0.7 minus 5 equals 0.2. Magnetic heading is 0.2. Example 2. Magnetic heading equals 2.4 degree. Deviation equal 10 degree east. fine compass heading. As usual, fill the table with the appropriate value. 10 degrees east can be changed to plus 10 degrees. We want to find the compass heading. Our calculation direction is from right to left, opposite to the general direction. Because our calculation direction is opposite, instead of 254 plus 10, it becomes 254 minus 10. Compass heading is 244 degrees. On the screen is a compass deviation card. The technician record residual deviation from compass swing operation onto a compass deviation card. This card is usually placed near a compass. Presently, the aircraft is pointing toward magnetic north. By referring to the compass deviation card, we can see that for north, steer north. For this particular aircraft, when we fly pointing toward magnetic north, deviation is zero. Since deviation is zero, compass north is pointing in the same direction as the magnetic north. Let's say we want to fly on heading 090 degree magnetic. From the card, it says that for east, steer 093 degrees. We need to turn our aircraft to 093 degrees. When the compass indicates 093 degrees, we are actually flying on 090 degrees magnetic heading. As you can see, compass north is slightly to the west of magnetic north. The deviation is 3 degrees. We can also solve this problem mathematically. The four columns on the deviation card represents magnetic heading. Therefore, magnetic heading equals 090 degrees. Steer column on the deviation card represent compass heading. Thus, compass heading equals 093 degrees. Compass plus deviation equal to magnetic. Place the appropriate values into the formula. 093 plus D equal to 090. We can rewrite it as D is equal to 090 minus 093. Deviation equal to negative 3 degrees or 3 degrees west. For a more thorough explanation of direction, please check my direction playlist. The link is in the video description. What do you think of this video? Please let me know in the comment section below. And if you find the video beneficial, please like it and share with others. By doing so, you will help other people to find the video. If you want to learn more about ATPL or other aviation related stuff, subscribe now by clicking on the round subscribe icon. Please check out my other video by clicking on the rectangular box. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.